Hey everybody, welcome back to Stormworks. A lot of exciting stuff. I did a few things while I was off stream, kind of get us more prepped. I wanted to redo our ship here. For one, I want to move on. I want to move on to a new design. So I want to kind of do the Mark II finish version of our little shippy here. So I made some adjustments. I redid everything now that we have more parts to work with and kind of organized stuff a little better. I was trying to give us more speed, but there's just not enough space in the back to rerun everything. So I'll show you what I did. I got everything finally decked out in our MidnightRice blue and white. I ran the exhaust and the intakes up through our little gantry overhang thing, I guess we'll call it. I did forget, though, to make it taller so we didn't have to crouch, but we're just going to deal with it. This was our first design. I redone the instrument clusters and reorganized everything. So now we have the throttle control. We have the motor start. I put a gearbox in, so hopefully I was running into a charging problem. I wanted to keep the motor at low R's so we weren't burning through fuel so much, because long distances it wasn't working out for us. So hopefully that'll work and we'll be able to hold temperature. I added fuse panels in, one for the electric motors and one for the main motor. We'll see how well those work. And I added our button still there for the lights. We have a fuel and charge gauge. I have an extra gauge on there in case we come up with something awesome later when we unlock more parts. I'll show you what I did in the engine compartment, which may look like a cluster. I wanted to run the bigger electric motors to the back to give us more speed, but there's just not enough room in this application. So I think what we ended up coming up with was a lot better. We were overheating a lot. Let me get down in here. So I did add two coolers instead of just one. Our big electric motor, well, this is the medium. The medium electric motor now goes into a gearbox. So we haven't tested it out yet, so we'll find out if that works. So hopefully that'll make, if I'm thinking about it right, when we switch up the gears, it should, hopefully I have that in the right spot, yeah. When we switch up the gears, it should spin this motor faster, right, and more electric charge. So we'll find out. We moved the motor to the back. And like I said, we ran everything. It's a little spaghetti mix in here now. We have the exhaust now coming up out of the top there. And then there, because I didn't like the exhaust pouring out the back. And this way, even the exhaust won't go underwater unless we flip over. Same propeller design, all that. Like I said, I just decked it out in our awesome MidnightRice blues. And let's go test it out. Oh, and that's the other surprise. Let's make sure we saved it. So this is going to be the C-Dart Mark II. And we're going to go ahead and delete the old ones since we already seen them. And I'm thinking we'll hold on to that in case we try to do another application. But this is the final version of this. So we're going to make sure that we save this. Do you want to overwrite it? Yes. All right. So this is our final version. No more after this. We're going to move on to a new boat. Let's spawn it up here. Oh, where are we? Aha! I bought us a new dock. I spent most of our money, unfortunately. We're down to 62,000. But here's our old base right here, which we can still use anytime we want. But it only could do the small boats. So now I bought is this one here, which we can do a lot bigger boats because we're going to start getting into the better stuff. And also what I liked about it, if I could stop, can I move the map? Thank you. Is for 50 grand, once we get some more money, we can actually buy the airstrip, which lets us do helicopters, cars, and I don't know where to build trains. I've seen trains on the workshop, but I don't know. But cars, helicopters, and you know that kind of aerial rescue vehicles. So we'll have our own little Coast Guard island, which I like a lot better. It's a pretty good size island too. We'll have to explore a little bit, look for more crates. That's pretty much it. So we got our little hut right over here. That's where we sleep, and that's kind of our home away from home. I wish we could, like I said, I wish we could have another workbench here to build like vehicles and everything, but apparently that's not a thing. So beggars can't be choosers, I guess. So there's our workbench now, which is not under a nice little shed like before. Still have the same crap fuel issues, which I hate this part. So hopefully I'm dropping that so I can, we're gonna have to dive down and grab this hose. I hate this part. Like I said, I wish there was a better way. All right. So, where's that fuel line coming down yet? Right there. There it is. So hopefully, without drowning, we can get this and get back up to our boat. Climb, damn you, climb. Like I said, I wish there was, they have to improve this fuel system. This fueling deal is a big hassle. Because this hose, you can barely swim with this hose in your hand. You just gotta kind of get lucky. But luckily, our bigger ships should be closer to the surface. All right, so I've added more fuel tanks, but it still seems like it tops out at what the one tank can hold. So I don't think that's actually our total fuel amount. I think that's just the tank, because you only can wire one tank per switch. So we could have had a whole set of dials here running to each tank. So all right, so we're full on fuel there. Hope I did it right. Get this off the boot. Bye. All right, so now what we have to do to start it up, we turn both of our switches on. That'll get both the motors going. We'll give ourselves a little bit of throttle to start out with. Should it start for us? All right. So if I did it right, I got my sound down, so I could barely hear the motor. Let me see if I can make an adjustment here. I want to be able to hear too. All right, that'd be a little better. So now what I did is I added this button here. Well, it's working. It did make the motor go down a little bit. So hopefully that'll keep our charge all the way up. And we can run at a lower RPM, because right now that dropped us to 4.58. Because I was running out of fuel fast. So let's see if this sucker still works. The back is sitting a little bit lower in the water than I like. So we're going to have a little bit of issue there. But it is keeping the props down, and it's keeping us up on plane. So we still steer good. Yeah, see, I don't think we did too bad. Now the exhaust is coming out the top, and the air breather is a little higher up, too. So when those waves hit us, we won't drown the motor out. All right, so let me test out our systems here. So supposedly, I think, if I... Where's the switch at? That's the diesel motor. If I hit that off, I shouldn't be able to... See, now that deactivated the electric motors. And supposedly that should kill the diesel. Maybe it's running because it's running. All right, let's kill the motor. I thought it would kill it instantly. All right, so now we shouldn't be able to start it. See, now we can't start it. So we actually got some controls here. Now we should be able to start it. Nice. So even at full throttle, this thing is only turning not very many R's, so I don't think there's going to be any problems with charge. Let's turn our lights on. Same light setup. But we were losing charge before, and we were going through fuel like nobody's business. So I'm hoping then this will slow that down. Yeah, I think we're moving faster, too. It was kind of cool, though. I did run the batteries down to see how that would work. And it does. As the batteries wear down, the boat gets slower and slower, even with the motor running. And see, now the motor's not... Like, before it was like, bah! You know, and it was really loud. And now it's kind of a lot quieter. So I'm pretty happy with our final version of this. I think we're ready to move on and maybe make a... I want to build, like, a tugboat or something like that. Something bigger. Something higher off the water. So we're going to get started on that. But I wanted to finish this one off. This will be our final version of our first boat. Kind of sad to see it go. Alright, let's dock it up. See, we're not even tall enough for the little bumpers. Alright, so let's try our shutdown sequence. Alright, so lights off. Electric motors and that off. Kill the motor. And we're off. Nice. So we do have more fuel tanks, and like I said, you can run a gauge off each fuel tank, and there's actually a way when we get into the bigger boats to build your own size fuel tank, I guess, but I haven't got that far into it yet. So, all right. So I don't think we have any missions up. If we did, we already failed them. Missions. Yeah, see, deliver equipment to power station, transfer crew. I think we failed them all. So you got 30 minutes to do that one. Well, we need cash, so why don't we do that one? We'll tag that one. I think we can do that one in 30 minutes. Let's go. We haven't put our boat away yet. Let's do a quick mission. It's only 9 kilometers away. Oh, crap, I missed the boat. I forgot that we need to do missions to make more money. I forgot I spent all our money. All right, so let's get this sucker going. There. All right, let's get out of here. Turn lights on. So I can't wait till we get a speed gauge. We don't have a speed gauge yet. I want to know how fast we can get things going. I hope I can make it there in time, though. I guess we will see. So I'm really happy with the final design. It is, like I said, it is got a little bit of weight in the back. I could put weights in the front, but I mean, really, I don't think it's going to be a big problem. But this is definitely, this is for calm water and close to the shore. Every time I've gotten it out in deep water with tsunami waves going on, I think the last episode we rolled it up, actually capsized it, and kind of cheated and got it back up. See, we're not bad. This is definitely a faster. I was going to put two more props on it, but I was worried about what that was going to do with the battery life. See, as it is right now, we're not losing any charge at all. We're running really low on the RPM, so fuel cost is going to be down. Oh, see, that tank keeps refilling itself from the other tank. So, yeah, I think we can go pretty far on this now. All right, I'm going to make the journey, and I don't know if we'll make it in time or not. But if we do, it's going to be awesome. So we'll see you in a couple seconds here when we get to the new spot. All right, so we're here, I guess. I think we're here. it is jet blackout. I have no idea where the docks are or nothing. This game does have really dark nights. It kind of sucks for filming because I can't see any more than I can see. I don't even see a dock. I know we're getting ready to hit land, though. Let's check the map really quick here. You guys got a dock here somewhere? I don't even see a dock. I see jet fuel. Oh, there's an airport here. This sucks. All right, well, I think what we're going to have to do is kind of as close as we can to land, and I'll have to run up there and grab these guys. The nighttime kind of sucks. I wish I could disable nights or... Oh, don't hit the land. Oh. Okay, so hopefully our boat won't float away. All right. So I'm going to leave everything going so we can find our boat again. Hopefully we can get up this little hill here. Are we going up the hill? This is bull. All right. So we got to climb a mountain to get to these guys. I don't think we're going to make it on this one, to be honest. I think what I'm going to do is once we get another boat built, I'm going to station this one at the other... Hey, rig workers. There's three of you, of course. So I have to carry all three of you. Hey. What is going down? Hi. Come with me. Oh, where's our boat? I think our boat's up and over this hill. I'm hoping I can find it. Please don't tell me it's floating away. Is that it way out there? Yeah. It should be down here. It shouldn't be that far out already. Oh, there we are. There's our little boat. So hopefully I can just jump right on the front of it here. All right. Hey, get in your chair. Oh, come on. I feel like I'm running a marathon here. Don't get me wrong. The missions are cool. The nighttime and the freaky weather every single day. I mean, we could have a couple nice days. It would be nice. But I guess that's the challenge of the game. I imagine in co-op mode, like multiplayer, I think this would be just stellar. Especially if you have a boat with a lot of controls on, you get to the bigger ships that have different departments kind of thing. I think that'll be pretty interesting. We might try it out. All right, I got an idea. Follow us. I didn't think about that. All right. Hopefully you can climb a hill, buddy. We'll at least get him close. Where did he go? Okay, it's right there. Because we have like 15 minutes to make it to our next destination. I'm sure it's like 9 jillion miles away. Of course. Still loving this game. Still loving it. I'm kind of excited. I want to get some cash here so we can build a new boat. Alright. So we're going to put you there. Where's the other guy at? He got stuck up on the hill, didn't he? We don't have time for this, you guys. To follow. Unless there's a dock, they don't seem to like to climb hills or anything. I don't think they have a jump command. Hey, I want you to be afraid of heights or something. Get over here. Get over here. Always waiting on you, Floyd. Always waiting on Floyd. Until... I love our boat in the Midnight Rice colors, though. That's pretty cool. All right, get in your chair. We got to get out of here. All right. How far away do we have to go? We have 13 minutes to get there. Come on, turn, turn, baby, turn. Run aground now would be bad. Oh, it's the same distance. That sucks. Oh, man. Okay. I don't want to do a mission an episode. All right, so you got the workers, and we'll be right back. Oh, man, I don't know if we're going to make it. It took all the time. We have 2 minutes and 30 seconds to get all these guys on that rig. I think what we're going to do is we're going to be more tactical about it now that we own two bases. If I would have spawned this boat from our small beginning base, that would have saved us a buttload of time. But so you got to kind of plan it out, and definitely gives you more reasons to buy islands because they kick these missions anywhere they feel like. So this is good. It's still good, though. We definitely need a big boat, and we need a super fast boat. And there's just no more room to keep up, make this thing any faster. So we'll have to make some super duper speed boat. Oh man, this is gonna come down to seconds, and I don't even know how to get up on the rigs yet. Where are you at? We need a ladder. Find the first ladder and get them up on that platform. Coming in hot. I mean, we're gonna try, but I don't think we're gonna make it. What the hell is the staircase? Oh, is it a regular staircase too? It is. It's a ladder and a staircase, and this boat's going to float away. We're going to try. I don't think they'll even follow us up ladders, but... Alright. We're just going to keep the boat running. You, come with me. You. I guess you're not going to come with me. Oh, do I have to get them all the way up on the rig, or can I just drop them here and have them follow me? Here. They count? No. At least maybe they'll follow me then. Because that looks like a staircase. We might still be... Oh, come on. Don't be a dick. Oh, it's going to suck to fail this. Come on. Just get us on there. Fucking hokey controls. 40 seconds. Come on, dudes. You're going to do this with me. All right. So you follow. 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 Let's go. Oh, you're going to be in the... You're not going to let me go past. Are you... Come on! Let's go. Dude, really? I set them to follow. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, we failed. You guys suck. Get off my boat. 12 seconds to go. Get off my boat! Alright, so we're going to plan it out a little better, but the next episode, we're definitely going to start building our new boat. Fuck this mission crap. Oh... I told him to stop following. Yeah. All right. Well, I hope you guys drowned. We tried. So we're getting out of here. We get in our seat now. Oh, I still have a guy on me. Get off. Well, you're permanently part of my crew, apparently. Bye. Apparently this... I will call you Roy. All right, everybody. I'm going to work on some missions and stuff in between streams and try to get us some more cash. But next episode, we're going to go back to our dock and we are going to build a new boat. I'm going to look on the internet and look for a real boat, and maybe we'll try to make something real. That'd be kind of cool. So, all right, thanks for joining us. Keep up with the series. Subscribe, like, do all that good stuff, and we will see you in the next episode.